JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFT's daily market review for December the 17th. I am Charalambos, Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFT, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar continued sliding against the other G10 currencies on Wednesday and during the Asian session Thursday. It underperformed the most against NOK, SEK, GBP and the Euro in that order, while it lost the least ground versus the Japanese yen and the Swiss franc. Now, the weakening of the safe havens US dollar, Japanese yen and Swiss franc suggests that markets continued trading in a risk-on fashion yesterday. Indeed, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that the majority of EU and US indices ended their trading in the green, with the only exceptions being Spain's IBEX 35 and US's Dow Jones, which slid 0.16 and 0.15% respectively. The upbeat morale rolled over into the Asian session as well, although South Korea's KOSPI slid 0.05%. Japan's Nikkei 225 and China Shanghai Composite gained 0.18 and 1.13% respectively. Yesterday, the main event on the economic agenda was the FOMC monetary policy decision. The committee decided to keep its policy settings unchanged, but changed its forward guidance, saying that they will continue to buy bonds until substantial further progress has been made towards the committee's maximum employment and price stability goals. With regards to their new economic projections, they upgraded their GDP and inflation forecasts for 2021 and 2022, while they downgraded their unemployment rate ones for the whole forecast horizon. The new dot plot revealed that still one member was in favor of raising interest rates in 2022, while five saw rates higher in 2023. In September, there were four members in favor of higher rates in 2023. So with the inflation forecast of 2023 at 2%, this continues to suggest that some members may not be willing to tolerate above target inflation for some time, as noted in the statement. The US dollar moved higher initially and equities pulled back, perhaps in the absence of a policy change and or the absence of strong hints that some sort of action may be in the works early next year. However, those moves were reversed, with the dollar resuming its slide and equities rebounding and trading even higher, Nasdaq hit a new record during the press conference following the decision. Fed Chair Powell said that the recovery has been quicker than expected, but added that they remain open to increasing bond purchases or moving to longer maturities, and if they feel that this will help the economy, they will do so. These remarks may have been the reason behind the reversal in the market's reaction, as they may have revived investors' hopes that the Fed will do whatever it takes to support the world's largest economy. Now, as for today, the central bank torch will be passed to the SNB and the Bank of England. Kicking off with the SNB, when they last met, policymakers of this bank kept their policy untouched, reiterating that the Swiss franc is highly valued and that they remain ready to step up FX market interventions when deemed necessary. Since then, the Swiss franc has gained notably against the US dollar, but stayed relatively unchanged against the euro. In our view, bearing in mind that the SNB paid more attention to the Euro-Swiss franc exchange rate, officials are unlikely to strengthen their intervention language. We believe that they will keep their policy unchanged and that the statement will be more or less a repetition of the previous one. Now passing the ball to the Bank of England, we don't expect any action here either. At its prior gathering, this bank decided to keep interest rates unchanged at 0.10%, but expanded its asset purchase program by more than initially expected. In the statement accompanying the decision, officials noted that the outlook for the economy remains unusually uncertain, and that they stand ready to increase QE again if market functioning worsens. Although officials of this bank are ready to deliver more, we don't expect this to happen now. Over the weekend, EU and UK Brexit negotiators agreed to extend talks over a potential trade agreement, something that increased hopes that an accord could eventually be reached. Therefore, we believe that the central bank will wait for the final outcome of the talks before deciding whether and how to act. A trade accord may allow policymakers to stay sidelined for a while more, while a no-deal Brexit may force them to cut rates into the negative territory for the first time in the bank's history. For now, the pound is likely to stay sensitive to headlines surrounding the negotiations. Anything suggesting that the two sides are getting closer in sealing a trade accord could result in more positive waves, while reports hinting that the differences gap is not narrowing, could hurt the currency. Tonight, during the Asian session Friday, another central bank decides on monetary policy, and this is the Bank of Japan. No material change is expected from this bank either, and thus the yen is unlikely to react. We believe that the safe haven currency will stay mostly sensitive to developments surrounding the broader market sentiment, with the Fed committed to do more if deemed necessary, US lawmakers getting closer in passing a coronavirus aid bill, and some vaccines already distributed in several countries, risk appetite may stay supported, something that will keep the safe haven yen under selling interest. Now, as for the rest of today's events, during the European session, we get Eurozone's final CPIs for November, but as it is always the case, they are expected to confirm their preliminary estimates. In the US, the building permits and housing starts for November are due to be released, as well as the initial jobless claims for last week. Building permits and housing starts are expected to have held relatively steady, while the initial jobless claims are anticipated to have declined to 800,000 from 853,000. Tonight, during the Asian Morning Friday, apart from the Bank of Japan decision, we also have New Zealand's trade balance for November and Japan's national CPIs for the same month. As for the speakers, besides SNB President Jordan, who will hold a press conference after his bank's decision, we have three more speakers on today's agenda. Those are Bank of England Deputy Governor Benon Broadbent, ECB Vice President Luis de Guindos, and ECB Executive Board Member Isabel Schnabel. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For all those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.